Hello. There are several tools to help you in speaking with users in your research. Tools to let people observe and reflect. Tools to help them express their experiences. And tools to help them explain. Tools to help you make sense of it. But it all starts with getting into context. With the context and with your users, who are the experts of their own experiences. Here are two context mapping tools you can use in the exercise and explain the principles of how and why they work. You can use them when you visit people, before or after making observations. From a mind map, you can derive the focus and scope of your research, what you want to learn. The first is to let them gather some facts along a timeline to tell the story of that day, including his or her morning ritual. It could be of yesterday or a typical day last week. Let them write things along a timeline, and this will help you to interview them about their experiences, what they find important and meaningful. The timeline starts at some point and ends somewhere. First, you ask them to mark down the things that they did, for instance, getting up or going to work. Once the facts are there, take step two, trying to uncover how they felt during this morning ritual. Which were the good bits? What did he or she enjoy? Which were the bad ones? What was experienced as negative? This can be done by entering some smileys and frownies. In the example, you can see three highs and one low. When you have that, move to step three. Let the participant explain why the good bits were good and the bad ones were bad. And finally, when you see those whys across the timeline, compare them. Are they related? Do you see patterns? Do they express underlying values? While comparing the moments, things may become apparent that your participant had not realized before. For example, how they enjoy taking a little extra time for themselves. On paper, it may look a bit messier than in the diagram we present. But usually, it helps people explain in their own words, and you can use it to ask probing questions. These values, the whys, may be more important than the single observations. They hold for the activities you observed and discussed. And they may hold in future situations as well. Understanding these values, the whys, is key to understanding the value your design can bring in the user's life. The second tool we provide is to map social circles. It follows the same steps as the timeline tool. First, focus on the facts. Then think of the relations and then explain why they are important. But this time, it starts from other people. Who plays a part in the story of their morning ritual? Again, it helps if you don't have to start from a blank sheet. Once the people have been mapped, take step two. What do these people mean to your participant? People who are more important can be placed closer to the middle. What do they experience as positive and negative? Why did they put some of the people closer to each other or closer to the center? Just as with the timeline, having the facts and relations spread out on the table helps the participant to tell his or her story and helps you to ask them about the what, how, and why. And just as the timeline tool, what they make can look a bit messy, but it will be clear to them. Here's an example where the participant made drawings and pasted pictures and words. Leave the format open so they can give it their own twist as well. The two tools provided are just examples. There are many ways to help people express their needs, but in each case, the principle is the same. Start with the easy bits, the what and who and where questions. Then ask what's important or good and bad. And when you have that overview, move to the deeper why questions. The two tools we just presented can be used to support you in interviewing your participants. They are meant to raise awareness of what matters to them. If you have conducted the interview in their surroundings of use, they can provide you with pointers that you can document with on-site photos as well, like the ones from the previous lecture. So now it's your turn. Go in and good luck.